the table. Bottoms up.
I've got nobody all on my own.
God, he's weird.
Are you sure you're related? He's so scrawny.
Ah, nah, that's just because we didn't feed him. All right, Big D, nice vest.
Thanks.
I'm being sarcastic. You look like a turkey in tinfoil. Stop beating up kids.
Very brave all of a sudden. You weren't last night in your sleep.
What was that?
Crying in your sleep.
Don't kill Cedric! Don't kill him! He's got so much to live for. He's handsome and charismatic.
It's so true!
Who's Cedric then? Your boyfriend.
That is it. I'm done!
Are you alright?
No, I'm not!
Don't you ever say his name again. You're not worthy. I'll kill you.
Oh my God, was he really your boyfriend?
Well, no!
If I'd have known he was actually your boyfriend, I wouldn't have joked about it.
You're gonna be sorry.
I'm already sorry. Please don't stab me.
Do you guys know what was really stressful? Cedric dying.
I'm sorry, what?
It has taken such a toll on me. Look at these crow's feet.
You had those anyway.
You're one to talk. I'd get a better skincare routine if I was you. You look about 70 yourself.
Rude.
I just really think a holiday would be really nice manoeuvre.
How about Hawaii?
Hello.
Oh my God.
Manoeuvre, I've got a tan.
Elbus, please put on your towel. You're scaring people.
What do you mean? I look good for my age. Besides, Sev's the embarrassing one.
What?
How is this my life?
Interrogator Cornelius Fudge.
And witness for the defence.
Albus Percival Wolfric Brian Dumbledore.
So you heard that the time and place of the trial had changed?
No, Fudgy, actually. That wasn't brought to my attention. Luckily, I've been sat next door in McDonald's for the last 3 hours preempting something like this, you little viper.
Boy, you produced the Patronus charm in the presence of a muggle. Do you deny it?
No.
Then you're guilty.
This is so dumb. I was being attacked by Dementors.
Dementor, Dementor!
Ooh. Also, the muggle in question is my cousin who already knows that magic exists. Harry, I'm your lawyer. Shut up.
Listen here, Fudge. You want a witness? Well, Mama brought home the bacon. Drum roll, please. Figgy baby, it's your time to shine.
Well, one of them was very large and the other rather skinny.
Not the boys. The Dementors.
Get it together, Felicia.
Everything turned cold, like all the happiness had gone from the world.
Better, yes, but more emotion.
It was like depression personified, like I could never escape.
Perfect! As you can see from exhibit this one, this is a bona fide Dementor attack.
Dementors don't just simply wander into suburbs and happen across wizards. The odds are astronomical.
Call me Miss Marple, but I don't think anyone's saying it was an accident.
Oh, excuse me?
Oh, yes, of course, you are excused. Please leave.
Fudgy, before her, we were tight, okay?
Listen to me, man.
If you run the Dementors, but the Dementors are running amok, you don't run them. Who runs them, Fudge?
He's not back.
Ugh.
Right then, this just got serious. Oh yeah, hands on hips serious.
You all ought to be ashamed of yourself.
The law clearly states that in a life and death situation, you can use underage magic.
It does say that. I thought that as well.
Laws can be changed.
Changed to convict people just because you don't like them? What is it? Don't like his glasses? Jealous because he's got a full head of hair and you don't? Upset because he's the chosen one and the only person who's going to choose you is that creep?
Look at yourselves!
A whole court proceeding for a case of underage magic.
You are all sat there making a mockery of justice. And if you convict this young man today, you do not deserve to wear those fancy hats.
I love this hat.
Same.
You will be just as bad as any Dementor.
You might not take his soul, but you'll be taking his future. Cleared of all charges.
Cleared of all charges.
Ha! Professor Dumbledore.
Who are you? Leave me alone.
What?
Now, I'm quite aware that Cedric Diggory perished last year. Of course, it's upsetting, RIP Cedric, but life moves on. Get over it. Yeah, I'm getting to you, man.
There's some new teachers. Anyway, back to me.
Minerva, what does this clown think it's doing?
She wants to stop. He doesn't like sharing attention.
He's like an ancient bearded baby.
Oh my God, the audacity. Is she getting up?
Don't you come walking over here. Don't. Stop. Stop.
Thank you, headmaster.
I'm gonna drop kick you across Gryffindor table.
We should maybe do something.
No, let's just let it happen.
Is Dumbledore shaking? Looks like it. Are you scabby ankle biter?
Your hat's not going to protect you when I sucker punch you in the back of your head.
Us at the Ministry take education very seriously.
Seriously, move away from my podium or you're going to die.
This year's going to be fun. So fun.
Go, shoo!
Did you not see that?
It was sexy.
Oh.
Okay, everyone, staff meeting. Minnie Moo?
Here.
Sevy Baby?
Here.
Poochie Mama?
Yep.
Popcorn?
Here.
Phil Phil?
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning, Phileas.
Not while I'm taking attendance. This is serious. Hagasaurus Rex?
All right.
Shouty Sprouty?
Present and correct.
Only you're getting dirt on the floor. Bug Eyes McGee?
Hello.
And Jabba the Hutt? Jabba.
Dolores, you're Jabba.
I beg your pardon?
Hey, Jabba, where's Jar Jar?
Minerva, don't do Jar Jar Binks like that.
I love you, Jabba.
Oh, it's so nasty.
So, please ignore the deformed gargoyle that has joined our class today. If we ignore it, it might go away.
Well then, you applied first for the Defense Against the Dark Arts position, correct? In fact, you've applied every year since you started teaching at Hogwarts.
Yes.
But you've been unsuccessful?
Obviously.
Funny, I didn't even have to try. And I hate children.
Me too. What do you have that I don't have? Dumbledore's not fair.
Well, at least Potter's mother got you ready for years of constant rejection. Speaking of massive losers, I should head to Trelawney's class.
Slap.
Bloody hell.
I had to slap someone and she's going to be my boss soon, so.
Yeah, it's not worth risking your job over.
Thanks, Ginger.
Could you just predict something for me?
My inner eye is sleeping.
Pity.
No, wait! I do see something, yes. You have cat plates because even animals can't stand you.
What?
You're thinking about buying one of those boyfriend pillows, yes? One of those ones that feels like it's holding you back.
No.
You're lonely because everybody hates you, yes, and you won't allow yourself to cry. But you still do in your sleep, and it's pissing off the portraits. Cornelius Fudge will tell you that his birthday's been cancelled, but it's a lie. He's just repulsed by you.
That is quite enough.
You will be kidnapped by centaurs and they will stamp on your piggy face and it will still be better than the face you have now. And nobody will get you a Get Well Soon card because they'll low-key hope that you never come back. Sorry, Professor. Did you say something?
Pack a suitcase. Something you would like to say, dear?
Oh, there are several things I would like to say.
Were you dropped on your head as a baby, Dolores? Did your parents not love you?
I beg your pardon?
Beg all you want, you haggard goblin. I'm just getting started. If you were my baby, I'd have left you on a doorstep. No offense, Potter, I didn't want to leave you there.
Oh, thanks, Professor. That's really nice. Listen here, you pompous pink-clad porcupine. Stop trying to bang the minister. He doesn't want you.
You make him heave.
Lies. All lies.
He told me he'd rather have a romantic night in with Voldemort, and he's a homicidal maniac with no nose. And it's not a wonder to look at you pink every day. What are you, 10?
Someone call Madame Pomfrey, because Dolores got burned.
Thank you, Minerva. Take Sybil inside.
Thank you, headmaster. Anything you'd like to say?
Skank.
Albus has been pretending he's in a musical all day.
Bonjour, 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 bonjour.
Oof.
There goes the crackhead that I see each morning. I wonder if she's feeling well. I am.
Every morning just the same since the day that scoundrel came.
Oh.
Everybody hates you and we think you smell. Today's meeting.
Welcome, everyone, welcome. Today we're discussing new insults for Umbridge. Gotta make sure we're cohesive, we're a team. It's professionalism.
So professional.
Minerva, you're a little roast lord.
When it comes to insults, I'm the goat.
Where do we start?
Alliteration is my signature, so I'd leave that to me.
Oh, but I think I could be good at it.
Go on, then.
Dolores, you dirty dingo. How was that?
30 points from Slytherin. For an insult to be effective, you need to think about how Dolores makes you feel.
Repulsed beyond belief.
Good, good. Now what else makes you feel that way?
Egg and cress sandwiches.
That's not good enough.
Fungus.
Yes, that's more like it.
Foot fungus.
Nasty.
Right, Severus, use that as inspiration.
Dolores, you scabby foot, get away from me.
Not great, but it's a start.
Ugh, it's been the longest day today. Minerva, please can we go back to your house and watch that show I like?
Which one?
The one with the funny Americans that are always getting into shenanigans.
Oh, I know the one. The one we watched last Thursday.
Ooh, yes. So no one told me life was gonna be this way.
Pa-pa-pa-pa.
Your job's a joke. You're broke.
Your love life's D-O-A.
But I'll be there for you.
That's questionable.
I'll be there for you. You're just really quite unreliable. I'll be there for you. We'll be there for you too.
Wow, Minerva, you really carried that. Well done.
Sit down, Potter.
Now, is it true?
Is what true, Professor?
That you shouted at Professor Umbridge.
Yeah.
That you called her a liar in front of her entire classroom and told her that he who must not be named had returned.
Well, yeah. Have a biscuit, Potter.
Have a what? What's that noise?
Sounds a bit like Dumbledore.
Oh my god! Lads! It's happening!
What's happening?
Minnie and Umbridge, round two! Fight! It's a real fight! Come on, the tea is scalding!
Oh, here we go.
Minerva, I think you're just a massive...
Are you gonna call me a pussy because I'm a cat?
Imaginative. Now listen here, you little hobbit. I will backhand you down these stairs.
Woo!
You don't turn up at my school and start cutting my children.
Sorry, whose school?
I will shove those quills where the sun don't shine.
Fred.
George.
Harry.
I have spoken to Cornelius and... Again, with the fudge thirst. It's embarrassing. You are a spiteful slug and nobody wants to spend any time in your vicinity, secreting your evil all over our castle. No wonder Filch follows you around with a mop.
I'll follow you.
Ah, it's so nasty. Next time I'll have you. I'm quaking.
Yeah, yeah. Bye, bye, bye. Get out.
Rude.
Harry, we've got a plan. McGonagall gave us some...
I don't care! Get out!
I am... Hi.
Hello, Harry.
I heard Umbridge gave you a hard time the other day. I'm sorry.
It's all right. It's worth it. I feel like he's watching over us.
Yeah.
Learning this stuff. I just wonder if maybe he'd have known it.
What are you talking about? He was a skilled and talented wizard, Cho. He knew this stuff. What kind of girlfriend are you? It's like you don't even know him.
What's your problem, Harry?
Sorry. I just...
Miss him.
Oh, me too.
Mistletoe.
I'm gonna imagine it's him, okay?
Same.
What?
He's doing this on purpose now. I thought once Cedric was out the way, surely Hermione's the next choice.
For goodness sake, it's not a big deal.
Not a big deal. I am literally invested in this.
The devil with Boris... And his rules? And since when did we accommodate them in history?
Since he threatened to sue us, Minerva. We're not made of money.
We don't want the students or staff to be catching COVID before Christmas.
I don't want to get sued, Minerva! I'm broke! Look how dusty my robes are!
Oh, for goodness sake.
We both got your note. What's the emergency?
I'm bored. Let's play a game.
We have actual jobs.
I basically do his as well. I want to play looks like.
How do you play?
It's easy. You'll get the hang of it. Okay, Filch looks like the child catcher from Chitty Chitty Bang Bang. He does give off them vibes, doesn't he?
Moaning Myrtle looks like.
Harry Potter in a wig.
Oh my god, she does!
Draco Malfoy looks like.
That boy from Home Alone.
Accurate. They go on holiday without him all the time.
What a loser.
Sybil looks like. She's on crack. That's not how you play the game and you know it.
Albus looks like.
Gandalf.
You shall not pass your exam. Damn, Slytherins.
Bullying.
Umbridge looks like. Roz from Monsters, Inc.
But worse.
Dumbledore, you didn't file your paperwork last night.
Well, it's true, you don't.
And that's why I have you.
Are you sure I don't have time to go back and put my hair in a bun? I just feel out of sorts with it hanging there all willy-nilly.
Forgive me, Professor, but I think your hair is the least of our problems.
All right, sorry.
Professor Dumbledore.
Minerva, you look amazing.
Ooh.
Your hair looks great like that. Accentuates your cheekbones. You look 10 years younger.
Professor Dumbledore.
You should wear it like that more often, like when we go to the bar.
I wish I could get dragged out of bed and look that good.
Yeah, McGonagall's hair looks great. Can we get to the point?
Oh, Potter, do you think so? Thank you.
I was thinking about doing something new with mine. Maybe a bob. Look at me!
Rude.
What? Your hair's the same as always, Harry. Just a bit sweaty. Not everything's about you.
Sorry, I don't mind.
Well, I do. My girl looks like a goddess and she deserves her moment.
Headmaster, you wish to... Minerva, looking good.
You guys are too much, honestly.
Baby girl, if I didn't bat for the other team...
They're such a good hype men, Harry.
I can see that, yeah. Anyway, why are all these depressed gingers in my office?
As you all know, Minerva took over the budgeting last year. So there's a little spare money in the kitty.
Ugh.
I've got some ideas.
Couldn't we use the money to employ a full-time psychotherapist? Potter's a head case. I'd rather he didn't wake me in the middle of the night, telling me that he's a sneak and he killed Arthur Weasley.
Cho Chang doesn't stop crying.
The staff could use it too. A portrait told me you've got a mannequin with a ginger wig on it.
Mind your own business.
You've never gotten over Grindelwald.
Don't say his name!
And I haven't been on a date since my husband's tragic death.
So boring! I've got two options for you. Listen to this. Inflatable obstacle course on the lake.
No.
Why?
The squid would try to kill the students.
Just adds to the fun.
Then what about a staff trip to Magaluf?
I'm never going to Magaluf with you again.
Heard about that one, Minerva. Didn't realize you were an accomplished pole dancer.
You shut your damn mouth!
I miss Grindelwald. He'd have come Magaluf with me.
Things we know. Dolores is annoying and it's making everyone depressed. You can't argue with facts, Dolores. Pipe down. And so, to boost morale, I suggest a school play, which I will direct.
Not again.
I've already cast the parts. The scripts are on your desks.
Oh, not a staff play, please.
There are some students in it too.
Almost makes it worse.
Do you want to know who you're playing or not?
What play is it?
The perfect play for us to do. Matilda. The cast list is as follows. Hermione Granger will be playing Matilda.
Makes sense.
Minerva, you're Miss Honey.
Lucky.
Well, he was Scrooge in the last one, so he owes me.
Dolores. Let me guess. You're the Trunchable. Filch, you're playing Cookie.
My sweat and blood went into this cake.
Both nasty and perfect.
Who am I?
You and Hoochie are playing the mum and dad.
Danny DeVito, I love your work.
You're gonna slay that I'm smart, you're dumb bit.
I do say that on the daily anyway.
The FBI agents will be played by Fred and George.
Oh, they'll do a good job with that.
Now for Amanda Thripp, I'm stuck between Luna Lovegood and Draco Malfoy.
I know who I'd rather see get thrown by the hair.
Albus.
What?
And Lavender.
Lavender's the hard part, because I would say Lavender Brown, but I haven't seen her today. I don't know if she's turned white already. We can't whitewash two Lavenders. We'll get cancelled.
Am I in it?
Bruce Bogtrotter, you're going to need to shave. Merry Christmas! Now open your presents, open them.
Oh, Elbus, it's, what is it?
It's a cat onesie from Primark. Very expensive, muggle brand.
Well, I've already got quite a realistic cat onesie, but okay.
Yeah, but I got us matching ones. I've got a phoenix one, Severus has got a snake one.
This is a sleeping bag.
No, it's not.
Yeah, it is. You've just painted it green.
You guys are so ungrateful.
Sorry, say again.
We're going to Azkaban, Dumbledore.
Nah, this is weird now. It's just, like, not going in.
Will! Shut up, you furry-faced troglodyte. Nobody's talking to you.
So this is what I got so far. You're jealous that I actually have friends and people want to be around me. And there ain't no Fudge's Army, because Fudge is a stupid name and Dumbledore's Army sounds way better.
Maybe we shouldn't have called it that.
I don't know. I just miss Cedric. Oh my god, me too!
It's embarrassing. We all know you're balding, Fudge. We all talk about it when you ain't there.
No.
I'm going to knock that hat off in a minute and show everyone. Umbridge, your outfits. Disgusting! I speak for everyone when I say I'd rather be blind than look at you. Mad Slytherin vibes from Doctor Who.
Slower? I've had enough of this conversation, actually. It's really boring. Besides, I see you all getting closer to me. Don't you know about social distancing?
Caw-caw!
Besides, my Uber's arrived. By the way, Fudge, this whole meeting, Umbridge has been sniffing you.
No, I haven't.
Oh! Yeet goes the hat!
Oh!
My hat.
You should shave it.
I love your hairline!
So, Potter, you want to be an Auror?
Well, yeah, that's kind of what I thought.
Well, you'll need to get excellent grief. Minerva, I don't know why you're giving the boy false hope.
I'm not. Potter has every chance of becoming...
Potter has about as much chance of being an Aura as Dumbledore being headmaster again.
So a great big mess of humongous chance, Potter.
That's my girl, you tell her, Minnie!
What's that?
Potter, if you really want to be an Aura, I will do everything in my power to make it happen. I will personally tutor you myself.
A little unprofessional, Minerva. Just because you failed to have children of your own doesn't mean you get to favour.
She did not just say that. I will come out of this closet. I don't even care.
Is Albus Dumbledore in your supply closet?
No. Have you met the man? He's never been in a closet in his life, you sour-faced dirt sack.
Minerva,
you get my pretty name out of your mouth. Get ready, you cantankerous cockwomble. I'm about to spit some facts.
Yes!
Oh my god, part three! Dumbledore, what do we do?
Just shut up and watch the carnage!
You are a petulant prawn.
What? Because I wear pink?
That, and because you're a low-life bottom feeder with a minuscule brain. I'd throw you into the lake, but even the giant squid knows better than to taste your bitter beef.
Reasons of filth, Minnie!
Well, your robes are fabulous and decadent. Do you see this velvet here? Handmade and tailored to me. Bet you can't get anything tailored. No seamstress would want to go near you, you bulbous flesh lump.
What have I done to deserve this?
Exist, you classless catastrophe. Not to mention causing bodily harm to my students on the regular, you reprehensible reptile. Also for being a minister-sniffing hog hag.
Harry, it's too much!
Sharp, Dumbledore, I'm trying to write this down for Hermione and Ron.
Hog hag. Encouraging Filch to simp over you. You're my Beyonce, Dolores. It's sickening. Now get out of my classroom before I shove my wand in your eye.
Fine, I'm leaving.
That was sick, Professor.
Thank you, Potter.
So, how was your meeting with McGonagall?
All right. She's really set on me being an Aura now. She was all like, I'm a pusher, Harry. I'm a pusher. What, like a drug pusher? I don't know. Bloody hell.
We've got a bit of a problem. Someone started a rumour that I'm selling drugs.
Oh yeah, I heard that one this morning.
I had a queue of 30 students outside my office wanting homework advice.
Yeah, I wonder who's been spreading that one then.
I swear to Godric Albus, I'm gonna beat your ass.
Minerva, I saved the situation!
Ha, try and explain that one.
The rumour already existed, I just added some details to make it less bad.
I am gonna throat punch you so hard!
A teacher selling Class A drugs to students, that's dreadful! However, a trusted professor selling a bit of the gillyweed as a side hustle from a reputable source like Professor Sprout, most of us are doing that.
Albus!
Only to the older ones! Plus it brings up your street cred.
I'll hold him, you punch.
Deal.
And then she says, I'm claustrophobic, Darren! They don't get it!
Albus, it's too much!
Oh, it's the Wicked Witch of the West, quick. I'll transfigure you.
Oh, frickin' penguin!
Enter.
Ah, deputy.
Headmistress.
Minerva, I'm here to talk about the lack of cohesion within the faculty.
What do you mean about lack of cohesion? No way.
Everyone hates you.
As my deputy, you are supposed to support me.
I don't support terrorists.
I miss Grindelwald so bad.
That toucan sounds like Dumbledore.
I'm a penguin and I'll peck you.
It's a hornbill and he won't. I want the same support you gave to Albus Dumbledore.
I am not going to braid your hair and tell you that you're pretty.
That's a me and her thing, okay? Best friends five ever because it's longer than four. Minerva, you are trying my patience.
Bold of you to assume that I need to try.
You're not worth any of my effort whatsoever.
You will regret this.
I doubt it.
Don't you want to know the secret of your scar?
Hang on, it's called secrets.
I'll tell you everything.
Right. Hey, Paris Hilton.
What?
I hope you've glued that wig on tight.
Stupefy! Harry, what's the plan?
Run, 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 run!
Damn it.
Give it to me.
It's not gonna happen, Elsa. Let it go.
Oh, hello.
Right.
I just want to warn you to not do something you'll regret.
Oh, what, like punching kids? Bah!
Oh, bloody corpus, bitch!
Regrets!
Hermione did it to me.
No, I've done it to you!
All right, Neville, come on.
Ah!
All right, Potter, just come for that prophecy, innit?
You ain't having it.
Are you sure, fam? Because I can fly faster than you can run.
Not true.
Give it a rest, bruv. You ain't even fast.
Stupefy!
That's cheating!
This has gone far enough. Reducto!
Oh, no.
Wow. You have nice skin.
Yeah, I do.
That was weird. What are those voices saying?
There aren't any voices, Harry.
Well, you said that about the basilisk voices and then again about my mum's scream, so why don't you shut up?
I can hear them too.
See?
Did you really think you stood a chance?
Well, I do beat you guys like every year, so yeah.
Shut up.
Give me the prophecy, or your friends die.
What about half the prophecy and then half of them live?
Harry! I just want to know my options. I'm under a lot of pressure. Oh, have you seen this girl's hair from the back? Proper messy, bruv. Prophecy, now. Aha, victory.
Hey, Lucy, want a sandwich?
What? Knuckle sandwich!
Everybody chill out, the fun has arrived.
Oh, I'm getting beaten so badly when I get home.
All right, cyborg man.
Watch yourself, I'm feeling a little moody.
Nice wig, Lucy. What's it made of?
It's Mum's chest hair.
Nice one, James.
Ready to die?
None of us are gonna die tonight.
Bye, Karen.
It's killed me, it's killed me.
Avada Kedavra.
What? No.
Bumbleo.
Please, no.
Bumbleo.
Harry. Why is he on mute?
Snap out of it, Harry.
Just give me a sec.
I'm done. Now I'm gonna kill you.
Ooh, coming to get me?
Yes. See, I knew I was fast.
Crucio.
You heartless, filthy half-blood.
Pardon?
Crucio, me? My cousin just died.
You killed him.
So?
You've got to mean it, Harry.
Oh, God, not you. Last thing I need right now.
I was only trying to help. I don't need your help. I'm just not evil enough for this.
You're weak.
Big talk, chicken arms. I ain't seen you at the gym recently.
Lies.
I can do 12 push-ups now in a row.
You should have stayed at home, old man.
Should have left you at that orphanage, but it's too late now.
Come on, fish face. Let's give these people a show.
Move, Harry.
Ow.
So, I'm a head out.
Maybe I should do that too.
No, Harry, you have to stay and watch.
But first, how's the lighting looking? Do I look good? Wind in the hair, is it cool?
Maybe you should concentrate, sir.
Don't tell me what to do.
Okay, fine, fair point.
Oh, ball of your breath, disgusting.
Okay, I see it now, I see it.
So, eat him.
Yes.
I know I'm a snack, but not for you.
Back, you fireworm.
Hey, Tom, I hope you grew some gills when your nose fell off.
Hey, Dory, you doing all right in there?
Ow, that's actually pretty cool, sir.
Ah, only pretty cool?
Get out the way.
Ow, why?
Not everything's about you. This is me time.
No. Oh,
see, Harry, that was your fault, distracting me.
Ow, 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 ow.
Man's blowing up the whole building. Vandalism, I'm not paying for it.
I don't have the money.
Don't you even stop.
Why can't you just help me out?
What? No, don't ask.
So basically...
Oh, make it stop.
She's smart. He's reasonably smart.
I mean, Minerva's saying that she's going to end up with Ronald Weasley, but I just don't see it.
No.
Exactly. A twin, maybe. But Ronald...
Hey, Voldy, why don't you just kill me at this point? Put me out of my misery.
Harry, no one likes a drama queen. So the bet started out 40 galleons, but I doubled or nothinged it in their second year.
Ha, rookie mistake.
Don't you laugh at me, you don't even wear shoes.
Did you bet on us when we were at school?
Of course. In fact, you were the year below Minerva. I remember she hated you so much and I was convinced that it was like gonna be a hate to love kind of thing, but obviously not.
Ha, can you imagine?
Yeah, in hindsight, that was a bad bet, and I did lose a lot of coin.
Hey, that's not fair. I don't speak Parcel Force.
He wants us to get back to business.
I tell you, since Cedric died, proper party pooper. We're ready.
Cecil, talk that guy, and then he just turns into a load of sand. Like, what a loser.
Oh, did we win?
Oh,
Mr. Sandman, give me a dream. Harry, do the butt bumps.
Oh, I can't right now.
Oh, you all right?
Oh, I don't think so.
You can't do this to me, Harry. I'm too young for you to die.
Oh! If you see a long tunnel, stay away from the light.
You've lost, old man.
Well, that's rude. I take it back, Harry. Follow that tunnel wherever you want. What's going on?
Look at me.
Nobody wants to. You're so ugly. Oh, no, he's doing yoga and he's possessed. There's no coming back from that.
Bagsy, I'm the leader now.
You know what? Nah, I've had enough of this.
Mate, you ain't all that.
What?
You're trash. I beat you every time and I'm a kid.
You will lose everything.
Says the man who lost his nose.
And his hair.
And his shoes.
Cut your toenails.
Manky.
And it goes a little something like...